that is a northern water snake.
And surprisingly, he has not bitten me yet. Ow. He bit me.
This video will be about the common water snake. The common water snake as a species can be split into two main subspecies, the northern water snake and the midland water snake. The northern water snake can be found in the northeastern U.S. The midland water snake, on the other hand, is found in the southeast, but its range never touches the eastern coast. One of the main differences between these two subspecies is their color. While northern water snakes are usually brownish or gray, midland water snakes can also have some reds or oranges. But other than that, they're nearly identical. Both subspecies usually have dark bands or stripes on the first third of their body, but the bands are replaced by large spots or blotches on the back two thirds. Some larger individuals have nearly lost their pattern and are nearly entirely brown. Speaking of large individuals, common water snakes can reach more than 4 feet in length, although when they are born, they are a mere 10 inches. Also, notice I said born, not hatched. Water snakes actually give birth to live young rather than laying eggs. Many snakes do this, including garter snakes, rattlesnakes, boa constrictors, and many others. Common water snakes eat mainly fish and amphibians, such as frogs. One of the first things you would notice if you were to grab a water snake is its attitude. If you don't give it a chance to get away, there's a very good chance that you would get bitten, and there would be a lot of blood. All this blood is a result of the snake's saliva, which has anticoagulants that make you bleed a lot more than you would otherwise. Despite this, the snake bites actually don't hurt. They surprise you more than they hurt you, and the bite mark will usually disappear within the next few hours. The water snake's teeth are so tiny that they don't actually cause any damage that will last for more than a day. Even though common water snakes are harmless, you should still be careful. They look very similar to some venomous snakes that live in the same areas, such as copperheads and cottonmouths. The northern water snake and northern copperhead are similar, but not the same. There are many little details that can distinguish water snakes from venomous pit vipers, such as the bars on the lips of water snakes that are absent from pit vipers, but if you're close enough to see these, you might be too close. In my opinion, the best way to tell if a snake you see is safe or not is to look at its pattern. Each type of snake has a different pattern or color, so you should very thoroughly learn the pattern of every snake in your area before you go out catching them. Finally, let's talk about exactly where you can find a common water snake. Their habitat includes pretty much anywhere near a stream, river, pond, lake, or really any body of fresh water. They can be seen warming up on a rock or swimming in the water in search of food, or they can be found under a rock near the water. That'll be it for this video, and I hope you learned something. I'm Micah. Subscribe, learn more, and go herping.